Welcome to the SISEP video on ensuring evidence-based practices are usable. For student outcomes to improve, one factor of the active implementation formula is having effective practices that are usable. For evidence-based practices to be usable, they must have a clear description of the program, clear program components, operational definitions, and practical fidelity assessments. In our video, we will follow Ms. Chow as she supports Mr. Wallace to improve student engagement. Mr. Wallace noticed the same two students always raise their hand to answer questions in his 7th grade science class. He knew that participation and engagement were necessary factors in the learning process. During a PLC meeting, he asked if anyone had ideas for increasing engagement. Ms. Chow, the instructional facilitator, offered to research strategies for their next meeting. Active student responding is a strategy for increasing student engagement. But before teachers could implement this new strategy, Ms. Chow needed to determine if it was usable. In other words, is the strategy clear and defined enough for Mr. Wallace to use in his classroom with fidelity? We'll start with a clear description of the program by identifying the philosophies, values, and principles of active student responding. Whole class lectures are often used in school, but listening to a teacher talk is considered passive participation and not an effective way for students to master content. A more effective strategy is engaging students in the learning process with active student responding. Teachers ask questions, and all students respond with either verbal responses, written responses, or action responses. Active student responding has been shown to be effective with students across all grade levels, ability levels, races, and socioeconomic levels in all subject areas. Now that we know the values and principles of ASR, we need to identify the program components. What makes ASR different from calling on one student at a time? ASR includes three core components: practice, assessment, and feedback for groups of students at the same time. With practice, teachers structure the lesson to include multiple opportunities for students to practice the skills. For assessment, students respond through written, verbal, and action responses, and the teacher reviews students' responses. For feedback, the teacher provides affirmative or corrective feedback to the students. But let's go deeper with those program components. We need to clearly operationalize each component in order for ASR to be used in the classroom. What does it look like and sound like? Practice. Teachers embed multiple opportunities for all students to engage in the lesson using unison responding strategies, such as choral responding or response cards. In choral responding, the teacher asks a question, provides a signal, and all students say the answer out loud. When using response cards, the teacher asks a question, and all students write their answers on a small whiteboard. The teacher gives a signal, and all students hold up their responses for the teacher to read. To ensure students have more opportunities to practice, the teacher develops lessons that require students to respond often and together. Assessment occurs as students respond to questions. The teacher constantly checks to see if students answered correctly or if there are errors. During choral responding, the teacher listens to hear if students all answered correctly. During response cards, the teacher looks at the answer to see if students' answers are correct. Assessment is not necessarily a graded activity, but used to determine whether students understand the content. During ASR, feedback happens immediately after each assessment. If all students are correct, the teacher provides praise and moves on. If most students are correct, the teacher provides praise and restates the correct answer. If most students are incorrect, the teacher provides corrective feedback. Depending on how many errors are made during the lesson, the teacher may decide to reteach that concept. For ASR to be effective, teachers must provide feedback to students' responses. Finally, we need a fidelity assessment to know if those components are in place so outcomes can improve. In other words, what would Ms. Chow observe Mr. Wallace doing for practice, assessment, and feedback while using ASR? In school, fidelity assessments are typically classroom observations of teachers using those core components. This would include observing the teacher asking questions, providing a signal, and giving feedback. The observation would also include a tally of how many opportunities all students were given to respond. Let's put everything together. In Mr. Wallace's class, ASR looked like this. Mr. Wallace wrote 5 vocabulary words on the board. He asked the class which part of the cell is often referred to as the powerhouse. The students wrote their answers on response cards. Mr. Wallace gave a signal, and all students held up their response cards at the same time. He then quickly scanned the students' answers and determined what to do next. Most of his students were correct, so he gave them praise. During that activity, Ms. Chow observed that he asked 5 questions and each student had the opportunity to respond 5 times. When evidence-based practices are usable, they are defined with enough detail to implement, observe, and replicate. Ensuring evidence-based practices are usable is a necessary step toward changing student outcomes. For more information about evidence-based practices, check out Module 6 on the Active Implementation Hub.